The National Severe Storms Forecast Center has issued a tornado watch for portions of western and north central Texas and southwest Oklahoma.
We got out the door as fast as we could, drove southwest, and it was drizzle and kind of rainy and overcast the whole time. We did not break out into sunshine until southwest of Vernon. I always went through Vernon. That's the way I got west. And on this particular day, I was with Eddie Sims and I decided not to go through Vernon. I said, let's go south and then west. Had we gone through Vernon, we would have met the tornado head on in the fog.
Vernon was hit hard. 11 people were dead. The damage was in the millions.
So we went south of Vernon and then west, and I looked north and there were huge storms going up. Motion that I had never seen before. And we followed it onto the northeast. Got close to Vernon and a mattress fell out of the sky. And then after that, I saw a woman standing out in a field and there was just junk littered all around her.
We went southwest of Wichita Falls, Texas, and we picked up not the first tornado, but the second one near the town of Seymour.
We were right in the damage track. I set up on top of a fence post and shot it. And then Eddie screamed at me until we left. And we cut in front of it, and some mud came through the window from the outer circulation of the tornado, through the window and across inside the car.
And then along the side of the road, a lot of storm chasers converged from NSSL and others.
We were low on gas. By that time, Eddie just wanted to quit. So we stopped and we met up with one of the other teams.
And we were all carrying on about how exciting this was and so on. And finally, I said, well, you know, look off to the northeast.
And a huge white cone funnel came out the back that we could see, and then it wrapped up.
There's another tornado out there, and everyone just scattered.
All the power was out, so we couldn't get gas. And the next morning, I had to hitchhike to Lawton to get gas.
We got into Wichita Falls, and the place was devastated.
This whole area of town is absolutely flat.
And I said, you know, I don't think we should be here. We're not going to gain anything scientifically by being here, and we're impeding the emergency vehicles. Let's get out as quickly as we can.
One of the oddities of the tornado is that after it happened, you could go out in the countryside on the south side of Wichita Falls and look out across the Mesquite, and there were, I don't know how to express this, I should have taken a picture of it. There were thousands and thousands of washers, dryers, and stoves. All these white squares, just thousands of white squares, because every house had a stove and a washer and a dryer. And they all went airborne, and then they were dropped out in this field, away from the main damage track.